It's a big day for us today because in our travels through the years, being football fans has been great pleasure to play in places like Wembley and San Siro, Atletico Madrid, played in the great stadium in Rio, played in Rangers Stadium as well and had two great memorable nights. But tonight we get to play in Celtic Park, which is a place that both Charlie and I, and for that matter some of the other guys in the band, great focus for us as kids because we're all Celtic fans. And it's something that we've carried with us through our travels. But up until tonight, I've never had the chance to actually play here. And if there was a night to play here, it's probably this event, which is going to occur later on, because it's the 40th anniversary, the club's greatest achievement. And although some people might be aghast at 40 years, that's a long, long time, why does the passion remain? It just goes back to us being kids and not only enjoying seeing Celtic win, but the manner in which they won, I think influenced us, even in the way we went about our careers. Because we wanted to make music that was positive. We wanted to make music that had a joyful effect. And although it sounds a bit of a stretch, I think that was the sort of philosophy of Celtic Football Club in the 60s as well. So tonight we're really going to enjoy every moment to not only be here, be playing, but to congratulate Celtic's best ever squad.
The Lisbon Lions, they're a kind of legendary football team from Glasgow who won the European Cup. They were the first team, in fact, in the UK to win the European Cup. So they all have a magical aura for Celtic supporters, especially in Glasgow. I'd first heard about it through a friend. He thought he'd heard that it was Simple Minds were playing for the Lisbon Lions 40th anniversary dinner. So I called Charlie and he didn't know anything about it. He said he would check it out. He thought maybe somebody had spoken to Jim, and it came around like that, really gathered momentum. The band weren't really sure whether this was going to happen or not, and I of course demanded to be included, being a Celtic fan. And it turned out Mel wasn't available, so we've drafted in another friend of ours, Jim McDermott. He's a great guy, he's a great drummer. And it's been great to play again. I absolutely love it. I couldn't remember any of the tunes, or at least I could remember how they went, but I couldn't remember how to play them. Some people will probably say I never knew how to play them.
The last 2 days rehearsing with them has been great, it's fantastic. This show, Celtic Park, will just be, you know, I wish we're doing more songs. There's a whole plethora of hits in there that I wish we'd dug out and just done about 20 songs rather than the five. Yeah, I worked with Simple Minds previously in 1998, recording an album called Neapolis. Which was done at Loch Earnhead when they had a studio there in Perthshire, Scotland. And we had a great time up there recording that. That was such a fantastic experience. And to be honest with you, I've always been a Simple Minds fan, you know, ever since watching the first live gig that I saw, not personally, I saw them on TV on the tube at the Ahoy Stadium in Rotterdam, and I thought, that's the kind of band I'd love to be in, you know, just that big sound, big drum beats, and you know, all that stuff taken from Sparkle in the Rain, Mel Gaynor's fills, fantastic, you know, really good.
You know how long I've been looking forward to this? When we knew we were supplying the P, but I didn't know I was going to do the sound, and albeit four songs, two of them are songs I really know and like, and the fourth one I've never heard. It was produced for Jimmy Johnson. But again, we do all the home games at Celtic Park. And it was Jim introduced us there way back about 6 or 7 years ago. He introduced there to supply the PA for the park. And since then, we've been every home game at Celtic Park. And being a Hearts man, that's really tough, I can assure you.
Lisbon Lions were probably the thing that actually, somewhere deep down, was the thing that kind of like made it possible to believe that you could be from a city like Glasgow and have, you know, aspirations to be something really, really on a world stage. Because I remember, and I know Jim has this similar memory, we actually moved from the places where we were kind of born, we moved to a kind of housing scheme where we kind of met together. On the day that the Lisbon Lions won the, or else it was that evening. I remember going up to see the house after they had won the European Cup, and my family's all Celtic supporters. It was a colossal day, and you know, just kind of reverberated everywhere, and it still does. And then Jim and I were really fortunate enough to meet the Lisbon Lions on countless occasions now and do things with them. And the thing is that there's a large part of them that has, like Bobby Lennox, Jimmy Johnson, a lot of them, I mean, their knowledge of music, and you realise they're music fans as well, you know, and their humour, all their humour in the team, and they're just obviously just such a special chemistry of people.
I'm ready.
Yeah. Lisbon Lions. Thank you, good night!